All right, folks, we're going to be doing another Bible study. This one is very shocking. And we're going to be reading from Genesis 17. And what's happening here is the evil of Sodom is rising up to God, and God has found favor in Abraham. So he basically tells Abraham that he's going to bring judgment to Sodom. Now, before we get started, I want to give you guys a little reminder. We're getting a lot of hits here at shockofgod.net, a lot of visitors, because you can get a free audio Bible here. So sometimes it's very busy. But when you go here, click right here, it says free audio Bible. Now, let's get into this. This is very shocking. And you guys love these Bible studies. I love doing them. You know, reading the Bible on YouTube is not really politically correct. It's not really something that this world in the year 2012 and beyond wants us to do. And I think as Christians, we have to be very careful that we do not filter the Word of God through this political correctness. In other words, you and I as Christians, we should never have to bow down before the altar of political correctness and be afraid to speak the words of the Bible. You know, my channel's been like attacked 7 times. I have 7 of my channels taken down for reading the Bible. But we read the parts of the Bible that are politically correct to read from. And that's what we should do as Christians. I think we shouldn't be afraid even if your channels get attacked down. What I like to say is political correctness can go to hell, which is right where it belongs. We're not going to be PC correct. We're going to be JC correct, Jesus Christ correct. So let's read to you some shocking, politically incorrect information here of how God judges Sodom and Gomorrah and what happens. And we're going to be talking about angels. We're going to have angels here that appear. And so watch this. We're reading from Genesis 18:17, and look how it starts off. And the Lord said, "Shall I hide from Abraham that thing which I do?" In other words, God's going to rain down his judgment upon the evil, wicked people of Sodom and Gomorrah. And he's like saying, you know, I should not hide from Abraham the thing which I do. And God says, seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. For I know him, that he will command his children and his household after him, and they shall keep the way of the Lord to do justice and judgment, that the Lord may bring upon Abraham that which he hath spoken of him. So watch this. Abraham starts being like a intercessor, so to speak. He starts pleading with God to have mercy, and watch this. Abraham's saying, you know, it's not right to judge the righteous with the unrighteous, you know, and watch this. But Abraham just is not knowledgeable of how evil and wicked these people have become. So the Lord says, because the cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous, I will go down now and see whether they have done altogether according to the cry of it, which has come unto me. And if not, I will know. And the men turned their faces from thence and went towards Sodom. But Abraham stood yet before the Lord. And Abraham drew near and said, now watch what Abraham says to God, wilt thou also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Peradventure there be 50 righteous within the city. Wilt thou also destroy and not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are therein? So in other words, peradventure, basically he's saying, look, what if there are 50 righteous within the city? Will you still not destroy it? And look what Abraham says. He says, that be far from thee to do after this manner, to slay the righteous, notice, with the wicked. And that the righteous should be as the wicked, that be far from thee. Shall not the judge of all the earth do right? So Abraham's here having this conversation with God. And the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. Now maybe Abraham starts thinking and he's like, you know what, I don't even think there's 50 righteous. You know, he's so what he does, look at Abraham here trying to intercede for the people. He says, behold now, I have taken upon me to speak unto the Lord, which I am but dust and ashes. Notice he's keeping himself humble. Peradventure there shall lack 5 of the 50 righteous. In other words, only 45. Wilt thou destroy all the city for lack of 5? And he said, if I find there 40 and 5, I will not destroy it. So this is pretty epic here. It goes on. And Abraham speaks again. He says, peradventure there shall be 40 found there. And God says, I will not do it for 40's sake. Now, Abraham starts really stepping over the line here, and he keeps pushing God here. And he says, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak. Peradventure, there shall be 30 found there. And God says, I will not do it if I find 30 there, you know, that are righteous. And again, Abraham says, behold now, I have taken upon me to speak unto the Lord, peradventure there shall be 20 found there. So now they're down. All they got to do is find 20 righteous people in this huge area, right, the city. And God even says, look, even for 20, I will not destroy it. And now it's getting down to where this is a pretty bad city if you can't find 10 righteous, right? And Abraham says, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak yet but this once, you know, one last time. Peradventure, 10. So Abraham whittles it down to 10 people, and God said, I will not destroy it for 10's sake. Now, this must be one bad city because they couldn't even find 10. And the Lord went his way, and as soon as he had left communing with Abraham, and Abraham returned unto his place. Here we go. Here we go. Now watch this. And there came two angels to Sodom at even. So at evening time, these angels come. Now, what's really interesting is when you read Scripture, many times angels appear in the form of men. They're not appearing where they have these wings like the artistic drawings, these big giant feathery type wings. They're appearing as men, in the form of men. And what's interesting is Scripture says that some of us have beheld angels, we have entertained angels unawares. You should look up that scripture. It says, if you look up the phrase entertaining angels unawares, where some people will be interacting with angels and they don't know it. So when these men come here, they're angels. Okay, so watch this. There came two angels at Sodom at evening, and Lot sat in the gate of Sodom. So Lot is like, he's basically like a judge of this city. You know, he has authority, you know, this city. And Lot, seeing them, rose up to meet him, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground. And he said, look, you can tell Lot's kind of ashamed of the city because he doesn't know who these people are. They're like just traveling through. He says, behold now, my lords, turn in, I pray you, into the servant's house and tarry all night, and wash your feet, you shall rise up early, and notice, and go on your ways. So notice, Lot doesn't want them to stay out in the city. He doesn't want them to see what's going on. He wants them to stay in all night where they cannot witness the evil of the city. And then in the morning, he wants them gone. But look what the angels said. They say no. Look, it says, and they said, nay, but we will abide in the street all night. And Lot probably freaked out, like, oh my gosh, you know, I don't want him to see. And he pressed upon them greatly. So Lot's really saying, no, you know, please, you know. And so basically, they go, all right, you know, Lot pushes, and the angels say, okay. And they enter into Lot's house, and Lot makes them a feast, and he bakes some unleavened bread, and they eat. But before they lay down, the men of the city, even the men of Sodom, compassed the house round, both old and young, all the people from every quarter. And they called unto Lot and said unto him, now watch this, where are the men which came into thee this night? Bring them out unto us that we may know them. So you have these very militant homosexuals in that city, and when it says bring them out that we may know them, they basically want to rape the angels, right? They don't know they're angels, but this is how wicked this city has become. So Lot goes out and shut the door after him. So he basically goes outside, he closes the door, and he's protecting his house. And he says, I pray you, brethren, do not so wickedly. He says, behold, now I have two daughters which have not known man. Let me, I pray you, bring them out unto you, and do ye to them as good in your eyes. Only to these men do nothing, for therefore came they under the shadow of my roof. And notice, they don't want anything to do with the two daughters. They just want to charge the house here. And they said, stand back. And they said again, this one fellow came in to sojourn. They're talking about Lot, right? And he will needs be a judge. Now we will deal worse with thee than with them. Now they start threatening Lot. Now, look, guys, nothing changes. The minute you say homosexuality is a sin, what do we always hear as Christians? Who are you to judge? Look, the militant homosexual community hasn't changed one bit. They're still the same as they were in Sodom and Gomorrah. Look what they said. And he will needs be a judge. In other words, they're telling Lot, who are you to judge? Nothing's changed in the militant evil homosexual community. And notice they threaten them. Now we will deal worse with thee than with them. And they pressed sore upon the man, even Lot. So they're pressing up against him. Like if you ever go to like a concert, sometimes if you're at one of these concerts where there'll be like a large crowd, people have been injured because this whole crowd pushes up against the people that are at the front of the concert, and they'll have to tell them to back off, right? And so you have this same effect right here where this crowd is just pushing upon in anger. They're pushing upon Lot, and the door's like getting ready to break, you know. Notice, and came near to break the door. So all this force is being pushed onto Lot. But the men, who's the men? The angels, put forth their hand and pulled Lot into the house to them and shut the door. I mean, these militant people of Sodom and Gomorrah were absolutely wicked. And notice what the angels do. The angels are not very politically correct either. The angels smote the men that were at the door of the house with blindness, both small and great. So they basically make it where their vision's impaired. And even though their vision's impaired, these men of Sodom and Gomorrah, they're so nuts, they're still trying to get to the door. But notice they can't see, and they're even wearying themselves to find the door. I mean, that's how evil they were. And the men said unto Lot, the angels say to Lot, hast thou here any besides son-in-law and thy sons and thy daughters and whatsoever thou hast in the city? Bring them out of this place. Like, get them out of here. Remember what God said? If there's 10, even 10 righteous, these angels were sent there to destroy the city. There wasn't even 10 righteous. For look, the angel said, for we will destroy this place, because the cry of them is waxed great before the face of the Lord, and the Lord hath sent us, look, to destroy it. To destroy it. And Lot went out and spake unto his sons-in-law, which married his daughters, and said, so he's talking to his son-in-law, look, we got to get out of this place, for the Lord will destroy the city. And they start laughing at Lot. But he seemed as one that mocked unto his sons-in-law. In other words, they think that Lot's just joking. They don't believe him, you know, like, notice, but he seemed, Lot, as one that mocked unto his sons-in-law. So they just didn't get the gist of it. So finally, you know, the angels are like, look, this judgment's going to come fast, and Lot and his family, they're like not acting quickly. And I think we are seeing a lot of this judgment come upon America. I do see that, not everyone in America, but I see America slowly, little by little, turning its back against God. And what's unusual, at the same time, you see this great increase of people that are Christians becoming more bold and more vocal and standing up, you know, for righteousness and truth, and saying to hell with political correctness. So as you're seeing, you know, the United States basically go downhill as far as turning away from the teachings of the Bible, what you're also seeing is, I'm noticing it, a newfound boldness in the Christians that are witnessing this. And it's just like what's happening here. Notice there's a sense of urgency to escape the judgment that is coming. And I do believe that God's judgment is coming. I think we are in the last days. I think with one hand, God is holding back his righteous judgment, and with his other hand, he's beckoning us to the cross, you know, escape the judgment that is to come. You know, you go through scripture, there is a wrath of God that is going to be coming. You know, in the book of Revelation, it actually says that the armies of the world go to fight against Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ destroys them. He goes to war with the armies of Satan, the Antichrist. Now watch this. So there's this sense of urgency. The angels, you're going to notice here as we read this, the angels have a heightened sense of urgency. They know that God is going to judge, and it doesn't seem like these people, that Lot and his family, are taking it as serious. And the angels, well, let me just let the scripture read to you as it is, as it shows it here. The angels really have to convey the seriousness of this judgment that is coming upon this city. It says, and when the morning rose, then the angels hastened Lot, saying, arise, take thy wife and thy two daughters which are here, lest they be consumed in the iniquity of the city. The angels are saying, run for your life, come out from among them, separate yourself from them. And notice what Lot, and while he lingered, look, he's just going so slow, the angels actually have to physically get his hand. Notice, and the men laid hold upon his hand and upon the hand of his wife, and they are physically getting them out of there. Notice, the judgment's coming, and they're making it out of there by the skin of their teeth. It says, and while he lingered, the men laid hold upon his hand and upon the hand of his wife and upon the hand of his two daughters, the Lord, look, being merciful unto him. And they brought him forth and set him without the city. They basically set him outside the city, said, look, you know, stand back. Notice, and it came to pass when they had brought them forth abroad, that he said, escape for thy life. Look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, look, lest thou be consumed. So you have the righteous, powerful judgment of God that is coming there. And now Lot gets it. He realizes the urgency of the moment. And look what he says, because he says, Lot said to them, oh, not so, my Lord. Behold now, thy servant hath found grace in thy sight, and thou hast magnified thy mercy. So he's thanking them. But then he says, you have magnified thy mercy, which thou hast showed unto me in saving my life, and I cannot escape to the mountain, lest some evil take me and I die. He doesn't know if he can make it there in time, right? And so he, notice what he tells the angels, behold, now this city is near to flee unto, and it is a little one. Oh, let me escape thither, and my soul shall live. So look what the angels, they have compassion on him. They said unto him, see, I have accepted thee concerning this thing also. And notice this, that I will not overthrow this city for which thou hast spoken. Haste thee, they're still rushing him out of there, escape thither, for I cannot do anything till thou become thither. Therefore the name of the city was called Zoar. You know, a lot of people will say, why doesn't God come back and judge right now? Well, and I've said that a lot of times, like, God, you know, you read the things that are happening in the newspaper and you see the evil that's going on in the world and in the United States, and I say, dear God, you know, how much longer till you return? I say Maranatha. Look up the word Maranatha. That's one thing that I use a lot in my prayers daily. Before I go to sleep at night, I'll pray Maranatha, Lord, Maranatha. And I think the reason why God has not rained down his judgment is for people that are unsaved, that people that have not fled, that have not fled the wrath to come and have not fled, like Lot here is doing as he's fleeing Sodom and Gomorrah. So like I mentioned earlier, guys, I really believe it. With one hand, God is holding back his judgment that is to come, and with his other hand, just like how the angels are taking Lot's hand, his wife's hand, his daughter's hand, you know, God's saying, look, you know, come to the cross, escape the wrath that is to come. So watch what happens here. The sun was risen upon the earth when Lot entered into Zoar. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven. Some people believe, you know, asteroids hit, meteorites hit. If you actually research Sodom and Gomorrah, there is some scientific evidence to the fact of, in that area where they believe Sodom and Gomorrah is, it looks like there has been something like this that has hit that area. So you should check it out. There's a lot of videos on YouTube about that also. And he overthrew those cities and all the plain and all the inhabitants of the cities and that which grew upon the ground. But watch this. It says, but his wife looked back from behind him, and she became a pillar of salt. This phrase, his wife looked back, it's not just like a glance back. What it basically is, when you actually read in its original translation, she's looking back longingly for that area. She's longing for it. And Abraham got up early in the morning to the place where he stood before the Lord. Remember, Abraham was the one that was saying, well, how about if there was 40? How about if there was 35? How about 20? How about 10? And now Abraham's witnessing this, the destruction of it. And he realizes there wasn't even 10 righteous. And he looked toward Sodom and Gomorrah and toward all the land of the plain and beheld, and lo, the smoke of the country went up as the smoke of a furnace. And it came to pass, when God destroyed the cities of the plain, that God remembered Abraham and sent Lot out of the midst of the overthrow, when he overthrew the cities in which Lot dwelt. So I would tell you guys, you know, flee the wrath that is to come. All right, if you want to read the rest of it, go to shockofgod.net right here at the top and click, well, actually, you can hear the rest of it. Click free audio Bible. Guys, I do believe we're living in the last days. There's a pastor here, Raul Reese, right here on the bottom right where it says Raul Reese MP3 audios. Let me click that. You want to go ahead and listen. This guy does, well, let me finish my sentence. You want to go ahead and listen to these also. This guy is a pastor out here in Diamond Bar, California. He is epic. The Spirit of God is with him big time. And so go ahead and notice how they're all MP3s here, and you can listen to that. He has here The Evil Sons of Eli, God Receives Praise and Judges Sin, Answered Prayer, Introduction to the Book of Samuel, all these. So go ahead and listen to those. God bless you guys. This is Shock. I love you. Escape the wrath that is to come. Come out from among them. Run for your life. God bless you guys. Have a great week.